Welcome back to Yoga with Brian. Today I'm guiding you a very short and very effective yoga practice for lower back pain. Lower back pain is not expected by everybody, but sometimes if we have lower back pain, this requires a very specific knowledge in order to practice and to enhance and strengthen the lower back spine, and that help you to reposition the spine and then help to move easily and then gain control and recover from the pain. Now from here, when to get start the practice, just get to a very comfortable sitting position. And from here, hug your knees closer to your body. When you have the lower back position, it's very important that you are aware of the lower back spine. Always keep that straight. So in this position, you try to pull your body forward, but keep the spine straight. Pull it closer, and you can lower your head down to your knees. Take a few deep breaths. Just lie and lean forward to your knees. From there, sit nice and tall and lean back a little bit. Pull your belly in so that it protects the lower back, it strengthens the core and help you stabilize the upper body. From there, use your hand, lift your knees up, and we get into a little bit Shavasana, Navasana, the boat pose with your legs extended forward. If the lower back pain is not as much, it's not very intense, extend your hand forward, still pull your belly in, activate the core. A strong core will help you to stabilize and strengthen the spine at the same time. Stay in this position for 1, 2, 3. You can drop down whenever you want. 4 and 5. Very good. Slowly drop the legs down. Pay attention to your lower back. If you had any problem or you feel any pains in the lower back, just stop and then get into a very comfortable child pose. The child pose is where you should lie down and then extend your body forward. But if you feel comfortable in this moment, then let's get flow into the next position. Now from here, extend your right leg and then keep your left leg bended and keep your knees high. From here, place your left hand at the back of your body. Inhale, lift your hands up and exhale, turn over. Place your elbow over to the knees and looking back to the back of the class. I want you to twist from the belly. The twisting will help neutralize the spine. Put the vertebra back into its position and have you feel better. Stay in here. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Very good. Inhale, lift your hands up. Strengthen the core, strengthen the spine. Exhale, drop your hands down at the back of your body. Extend two of your legs and then bend your right knees. Okay, from here we do to the other side. Drop your right hand at the back. Inhale, lift your left hands up. Exhale to the other side. And stay with me. 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. Very good. Inhale, lift your hands up. Exhale, down. Drop your hands at your back. Extend your legs forward. Just sit nice and tall and let your spine be really strong and strengthened. Now from here, bend your knees. We get into the third position of today's practice. Bend your knee and then lift your knees up and down, relaxing and releasing the tension in the hips area. So when you do this, try to lower down the knees to the floor. Flexible hip also have a lot for lower back pains because it helps you move more easily. From here, use your hand to grab the feet together and press your elbow down to the legs and push your knees down to the floor. Open your hip widely. You don't have to lower your body, lower your head down to your feet immediately. In this position, it's very important that you pull your body forward and keep your spine straight. Use your belly, protect your lower back. Sway your core. You don't have to lower your shoulders down. Just keep it comfortable by pressing the elbow to push your knees down. Follow your breath. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Very good. Lift your body up. And from here, we push your body up into Asian squat. Asian squat is where you sit down on your heels and your legs and with your legs bent. And I want you to press your hands. Keep your spine straight. Push your elbow to your legs. Open your legs. This practice will help you lengthen the hamstring. Open your hip wider and make the hip flexible to easily move your body without injuring the lower back. In this position, it's very important to keep your spine straight and once again, pay attention to your lower back. Rock side to side. One, two, three, four, and five. Lie down to the floor. Place your right hand over the left leg and from here, twist over. Change the side and slowly twist to the right leg. We've just finished the practice for lower back. Now, if you have any question, leave it below. and I hope you improve your low back and get into joy and happiness when you practice yoga as well as when you move along your day. Hope you have a good week. Namaste.